Shazam!
Hey y'all, how y'all doing? Welcome to Underdeveloped. And today, we're doing a movie. A movie that I've been waiting to do for a while. We finally got to it. L.A. Confidential. Heard nothing but great things about it.
4216 Evergreen. Parole violation, assault, arrest. Guy's been out of queue 2 weeks.
Leave it for later. We gotta pick up the rest of the booze and get it to the station.
Hollywood, this is 6 Adam 7. Have Central send a prowler to 4216 Evergreen. Parole violation, assault arising from a family dispute. We won't be here, but they'll see him.
That's one way to get his attention.
Who in the hell are you?
Ghost of Christmas Past. Did you dance with the man for a change?
What are you, some kind of smartass?
Ooh!
You'll be out in a year and a half. I'll get cozy with your parole officer. You touch her again, I'll have you violated on a kitty raper beef. You know what they do to kitty rapers in Quentin.
It's really interesting hearing him with an American accent.
Yeah, it is a little jarring.
Drop the formalities, Bobby. It's Christmas Eve.
Call me Dudley.
Dudley, I came up with a title for the story. I'm calling it Silent Night with the LAPD.
Oh, that's grand. Now remember, Bobby, that's Smith with an S.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Merry
Hold Christmas. On there, lads.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you.
I saw the test results on the lieutenant's exam. First out of 23. What'll it be then? Patrol Division, Internal Affairs, what?
I was thinking Detective Bureau.
Edmund, you're a political animal. You have the eye for human weakness, but not the stomach.
You're wrong, sir.
Would you be willing to plant corroborative evidence on a suspect you knew to be guilty in order to ensure an indictment?
Dudley, we've been over this.
Yes.
That's sir. Not legal.
No, it's not.
He said he has to be criminal to do a specific thing? What the fuck are you talking about?
Well, Edmund.
No.
Would you be willing to beat a confession out of a suspect you knew to be guilty?
No.
Illegal?
Would you be willing to shoot a hardened criminal in the back in order to offset the chance that some lawyer...
No.
Then, for the love of God, don't be a detective. Stick to it.
So, be a detective, you gotta be an asshole who breaks the law?
Yeah.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, in his eyes, to be a detective means be immediately suspicious of someone and then do what you can to make him look as bad as possible, even though he hasn't done anything yet.
Yeah, I mean, that kind of pertains to some reality.
Yeah.
Assignments where you don't have to make those kind of choices.
Dudley, you should make those choices. Those are wrong choices. That's
but
illegal.
I don't need to do it the way you did. Or my father.
At least get better respect us all. I can't think of a single man in the bureau who wears them.
Break it up. Come on. She's got too much.
Get back. Get back.
Yeah, and fuck your mother.
Fuck you.
Oh, God. They locked him in there. What the fuck? God, this is chaos. Someone's going to die in this mess, aren't they?
Anthony Trombino, two rising lieutenants in the Mickey Cohen rackets. With a dapper little gent in prison, who knows how far they'll go? The sky's the limit.
Well, they surely didn't go far.
to dreamland. You're my
baby. It came as they went.
Yep.
Dig in the land of night.
Meet Deuce Perkins, Mickey Cohen's narcotics lieutenant. Could he be behind the hits?
He's gonna die too, isn't he?
Consolidating organized crime power? I suppose not.
I'm shocked that that couch didn't get stained.
One thing's for sure, two-man triggers are punching the tickets on the mixer's muscle.
Time to hit the road.
What in the Godfather's going on here?
Huh. I'm bloody over there. Oh, was someone shot and their body dragged? Okay. Leaving a literal trail of blood. Yikes. Wow.
Whoa.
I want barricades both ends of the street. Make sure the traffic doesn't...
Sir, I took the call. It's my case.
You don't want it, Edmund, and you can't have it.
I took the call.
It's mine. I'll make you my second in command.
Captain Smith, over here, please.
Back door! Nobody else inside!
Looks like the cook drew a handgun and set it off. The rest were killed in the men's room.
Sir, we got a total of 15 spent 12-gauge Remington shotgun shells. I'm betting 3 men, 5-shot capacity pumps, all of them emptying once.
Excuse me, sir. We got an ID on one of the victims. It's Dick Stenslin.
You know, when I first saw her, I thought she was...
One day into his retirement, yeah, not even.
Yep.
Immediate death.
That's wild.
No, hey, Dollface. Come to leave us alone.
I understand. Okay, fine. Mm. Oh, baby. Bad news. You have to go.
Go?
Something very important has come up and you have to go, but I'll make it up to you, okay? I will, I promise. Excuse me.
Oh, I hope your friend owes you something.
Is it the cops?
Miss Bracken, I'm Officer White.
I've been expecting you, just not this soon. Pierce called. He told me what happened to Sue.
Everything all right, doll? Want me to get rid of him? Get the rope, pal. Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. LAPD shitbird, get the fuck out of here, or I'll call your wife to come get you.
Yeah.
Yep, I'm out.
Yeah. Officer.
Councilman.
Councilman! Wow! Okay.
Still get to act a little.
Tell me about Pierce.
He's waiting for you to mention money.
You want some advice, Miss Bracken?
It's Lynn.
Miss Bracken, don't ever try to fucking bribe me or threaten me, or I'll have you and Patchett and shit up to your ears.
I remember you from Christmas Eve. You have a thing for helping women, don't you, Officer White?
Maybe I'm just fucking curious.
You say fuck a lot.
You fuck for money.
There's blood on your shirt. Is that an integral part of your job?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy it?
When they deserve it.
Did they deserve it today?
I'm not sure.
But you did it anyway.
Yeah. Just like the half dozen guys you screwed today.
Well, actually, it was only two. You're different, Officer White. You're the first man in 5 years who didn't tell me I looked like Veronica Lake inside of a minute.
You look better than Veronica Lake. Pierce Patchett.
He takes a cut of our earnings and invests it for us. Doesn't let us use narcotics, and he doesn't abuse us. Can your policeman's mentality grasp those contradictions?
He had you cut to look like Veronica Lake.
No. I'm really a brunette, but the rest is me. And that's all the news that's fit to print. It's nice meeting you, officer.
I'd like to see you again.
Are you asking me for a date or an appointment?
I don't know.
If you're asking me for a date, I should know your first
name. Forget
I
asked. It was a mistake. You haven't even asked me what this is about.
Oh shit, Mr. Setout, bitch, I'm dead. Big... From Lucifer.
He runs a hole up on Bunker Hill.
Holy shit.
He sells Red Devils.
Actually, it's good, I'll give him that.
I'm gonna take a break.
You know, Ray, I'm talking about the gas chamber, and you haven't even asked me what this is about.
You got a big guilty sign around your neck.
That was masterful, Edmund. This one's ready to go.
Oh, shit.
Give Jones the newspaper. I want him primed.
And take the cuffs off so he can read it.
Ray Collins just ratted you off. Said the night owl was your idea.
I think it was Ray's idea.
That's the exact bullshit that cops do.
Yep.
They feed you false. When I actually was the one that reported a crime, I went to the police station to do so, and they try to fucking paint a whole different picture. I'm like, nigga, I just told you. What the fuck are you talking about? Like, I'm here late at night, beat up, fucking seven niggas jumped me, my face is swelled up, talking about I got robbed. Are you trying to think, you thinking I did something? What the fuck are you talking about?
And save your life.
Yeah. Every time you tell that story, this seems more and more wild. Like, how the
hell? Like,
they're so full of shit, they're really trying to pin that on you.
Lewis, he called you queer. Said at casitas you took it up the ass.
I didn't kill nobody!
Son. You know what's gonna happen to you if you don't talk. You'll go to the gas chamber, so for God's sake, admit what you did.
I didn't mean to hurt her. Maybe she's okay.
Okay. Well, these people are all in the morgue. They were dead when you left them.
I just wanted to lose my cherry. She don't die, so I don't die. She don't die, so I don't die.
Lewis, who's the girl? What's her name?
Who are you talking about? Was she at the night owl? Lewis, listen to me. Was she at the night owl?
She don't die, so I don't
die. This newspaper shit ain't shit.
That
where's the girl
Fontaine's
talking about?
Did you kill her? You wanted Lewis to lose his cherry, but that wasn't enough. So things got out of hand, and you made her bleed. She bled on your clothes, so you burned the clothes.
I told you that!
Now listen to me.
If
that girl is still alive, she's the only chance you've got.
I think she's alive!
You think?
Then where is she now?
Did you leave her someplace? Did you sell her out?
Tell me where she is!
Move!
Good cop, bad cop.
Forensics! Where's the girl?
How is he supposed to answer if he has a gun in his mouth, dick?
What? Sylvester Fitch. 109 Avalon. Brown Court.
He's much more tough than the other guy. Other guy would be like, whoa, whoa, whoa!
Yes.
Thank you.
Ugh. At least she's alive. Fucking dick.
I ain't saying anything. It ain't even deserve it, but damn.
Yeah.
Yeah, this dude's like a puncher.
Definitely.
He gives his own brand of justice. All these officers in this movie have their own different personalities.
Went around back, sir.
Miss, I'm Lieutenant Exley. I'm sorry to have to ask you this. I need to know what time they left you.
Get her to the hospital.
I'm gonna sit up like this because if I go back, if I leave back, I'm just gonna knock out again.
I realize this is difficult.
Give you trying to get this movie done.
Leave her alone. A naked guy with a gun? You expect anyone to believe that?
Get the fuck away from me.
How's it gonna look in your report?
It'll look like justice. That's what the man got. Justice.
You don't know the meaning of the word, you ignorant bastard.
Yeah? Well, you think it means getting your picture in the paper. Why don't you go after criminals for a change instead of cops?
Stensland got what he deserved, and so will you.
Damn! That's cold.
Vincennes, I need your help with something.
I'm busy right now. Why don't you just go ask some of your boys in homicide?
I can't. I need someone outside of homicide. I want you to tail Bud White till he goes on duty this evening.
Why don't you do me a real favor and leave me alone?
Do you make the three Negroes for the Night Owl killings?
What?
It's a simple question.
Why in the world do you want to go digging any deeper into the Night Owl killings, Lieutenant?
Rollo Tomasi.
Is there more to that, or am I supposed to guess?
Rollo was a purse snatcher. My father ran into him off duty. And he shot my father 6 times and got away clean. No one even knew who he was. I just made the name up to give him some personality.
What's your point?
Rollo Tomasi's the reason I became a cop. I wanted to catch the guys who thought they could get away with it. It was supposed to be about justice. Then somewhere along the way, I lost sight of that. Why'd you become a cop?
I don't remember. White's not so dumb after all.
You guys are just gonna stand there and watch the whole time?
Yeah, these guys is perving now.
Yeah.
So
We got Rita Hayworth at the morgue, and now Veronica Lake.
And they stayed there for another hour for the
life. I think your case and my case are somehow connected. It's fleur-de-lis again.
Fleur-de-lis?
Yeah. Whatever you desire. Porno. High-class whores, cut to look like movie stars. Who knows what else? Reynolds, the kid that got killed, was involved. So's Pearce Patchett.
The millionaire?
Yeah, I think we should go talk to him.
First, I want to brace Stompanato.
Want an autograph? Right to MGM.
Since when do two-bit hoods and hookers give out autographs?
What did you say to me?
LAPD, sit down.
Who in the hell do you think you are?
Ed, take a walk, honey, before I haul your ass downtown.
You are making a large mistake.
Get away from our table.
Shut up. A hooker cut to look like Lana Turner is still a hooker.
Hey!
She just looks like Lana Turner.
She is Lana Turner.
What?
She is Lana Turner.
That's funny.
How was I supposed to know?
His fucking face. He just wants to bust out laughing.
You were smart. He also said you were a coward and that you'd screw yourself to get ahead.
Well, let's concentrate on my smarts. Pearce Patchett made you, didn't he? Taught you how to dress, talk, and think. And I am very impressed with the results. But I need some answers. And if I don't get them, I'm going to take you and Patchett down.
Pearce Patchett can take care of himself. And I'm not afraid of you. And you forget one thing, Lieutenant. Pearce also taught me how to fuck.
And he tells you who to fuck. Why does he have you fucking Bud White?
What makes you think I'm not seeing Bud because I want to? It would be easier for you if there was an angle, wouldn't it? You're afraid of Bud because you can't figure out how to play him. He doesn't follow the same rules of politics as you do. Makes him dangerous.
I can handle Bud White.
Can you? I see Bud because I want to. I see Bud because he can't hide the good inside of him. I see Bud because he makes me feel like Lynn Bracken and not some Veronica-like look-alike who fucks for money. I see Bud because he doesn't know how to disguise who he is. I see Bud for all the ways he's different from you.
Don't underestimate me, Miss Bracken.
The way you've underestimated Bud White.
Oh.
Fucking me and fucking Bud aren't the same thing, you know.
Stop talking about Bud White.
Okay. Of course.
Okay.
Deadly. It's important.
That's a good thing for you. My wife and four fair daughters are at the beach in Santa Barbara.
Do you remember Buzz Meeks, Dudley?
A disgrace as a police officer. Straight D fitness reports from every CO he ever served under. What about him?
12 years ago, he was on a vice rouse with Dick Stensland. They questioned Pearce Patchett about a
a blackmail scam. Patchett had Sid Hudgens photographing prominent businessmen with hookers. Anyway, charges were dropped. Insufficient evidence. You were the supervising officer on that case, and I was wondering if you remember anything about it.
What's this all about, Boyle?
Part of it has to do with a murder. I've been working with Ed Exley on it.
You're a narco, Jack, not homicide. Since when do you work with Edmund Exley?
Well, it's a private investigation. I messed something up. I'm trying to make amends.
Don't start trying to do the right thing, Boyle. You haven't had the practice? Buzz Meeks and Dick Stenson. What does Exley make of all this?
No, I haven't told him yet. I just came straight from the records room.
Yeah.
What did I say?
Mm-hmm.
Corrupt fuck.
Yeah, this really isn't surprising at all.
Have you a valediction, boyo?
Sergeant Vincennes was killed by a .32 slug to the heart. Time of death, approximately 1 a.m. Although he was found in Echo Park, preliminary forensics indicates the body was most likely moved. I want two-man teams to scour that entire neighborhood. Our justice must be swift and merciless. That is all. Edmund, I'm gonna have a word with you. We're trying to run down a lead on an associate of Vincennes. The records check has led to a dead end.
What's the name?
Rollo Tomasi. You ever heard Vincennes mention him?
No, I haven't.
Oh, that's clever. Huh. That's how he got the word out that he's the one who killed him.
Still.
Because that's the name that fucking guy Pearce made up. Very clever.
Just for a moment.
Now put a bullet in his face.
Somebody did have that much heroin. Who would they go to?
Fuck someone, prosecute him. Just shoot him.
Wait.
Talk to Exley.
Coming out of the rain.
I want to know what happened with Exley.
He's coming.
Are you going to tell me what happened with you and Exley?
We talked.
He loved you.
Dude, no! You knew she was a prostitute anyways.
He saved you.
Damn.
Well, you can come to your father.
Yep. He has become the thing he hates the most. Why did he take his glasses off to read when he needs them to see?
He's probably farsighted. He doesn't need it to be close.
White, I'm glad you're here. I need you to see this.
Yeah, nah, he ain't hearing some
shit. No. Yeah. Oh god, he needs therapy.
Dude, he needs someone to fight back on his ass.
Dudley killed Jack. He wants you to kill me. He showed you the photo, didn't he? Didn't he?
Oh, God damn you, fucking brute. He is not a beautiful mind.
Nope. Oh, God.
You can't just go around destroying shit, dude. You're not Godzilla.
This Godzilla-sized temper, though.
I checked the daily report books. Dudley, Buzz Meeks, and Stensland go way back.
I know Stensland lied to me. Leffert's mother ID'd Stensland as Leffert's boyfriend. Stensland pretended he didn't know Meeks or her the night that I met Lynn.
Stensland and Meeks, what the hell were they up to?
I don't know. But I think Stens killed Meeks over heroin.
What heroin?
Tony Stompanato told me that Meeks had heroin for sale. Meeks ends up dead. Stensland dies at the Night Owl.
It wasn't the Negroes. The rape victim lied in her statement. The first guys to the Mercury Coupe were Bruning and Carlisle.
Dudley's guys. They planted the shotguns.
And they'd have killed the Negroes too if Jack and I hadn't shown up. Dudley framed them because they were Negroes and had records. And he knew there'd be no questions asked if they were killed resisting arrest. Somehow this is all connected to Jack's angle. Sid Hutchins. The pictures to blackmail Ellis Lowe. A kid got murdered. If we're gonna figure this out, we need to work together.
Why are you doing this? The Night Owl made you. You want to tear all that down?
With a wrecking ball. You want to help me swing it?
Let's go see Ellis Lowe. Find out what the district attorney knows.
Hey, you can't go in there. Do you want me to call the police, Mr. Lowe?
Ask for Captain Dudley Smith. Tell him we're having a discussion about the death of an unemployed actor at a Sunset Strip motel.
These are, please.
What do you want?
I want DA Bureau men to tail Dudley Smith and Pearce Patchett 24 hours a day. I want you to get a judge to authorize wiretaps on their home phones, and I want authorization to check their bank records.
On what evidence?
Call it a hunch.
Absolutely not. Dudley Smith is a highly decorated member of this police department. I'm not going to smear his and Pierce Patchett's name without having...
Without what? Them smearing yours first? What do they have on you, Lowe? Pictures of you and Matt Reynolds with your pants down?
You have any proof?
The proof had his throat slit. So far, you're not denying it.
Well, I'm not going to dignify this with answers. Now, if you gentlemen will excuse me, I have a press conference for Jack Vincennes that I have to prepare for.
Unless you came here to wipe my ass, I believe we're through.
Come on, don't pull that good cop, bad cop crap. I practically invented it. So what if some homo actor is dead, huh? Boys, girls, 10 of them get off the bus to L.A. every day.
Yeah, go do that to the district attorney.
Pull him off me, Exley!
I don't know how.
Now, I know you think you're the number one hotshot, but here's the juice. If I take you out,
10 more lawyers will take your place tomorrow. They just won't come on the bus, that's all.
Jesus Christ!
This guy's insane.
All right, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Dudley and Patchett. Thanks. Oh my God.
I wouldn't play ball, so they set me up. And then I gave in, but the kid heard everything. Oh, so they killed him. No.
Why? What are Dudley and Patchett up to?
They're taking over Mickey Cohn's rackets because of those pictures. I couldn't prosecute them. Oh, Jesus, help me out.
It's as good a place as any for it to end. Here, clip. All I ever wanted was to measure up to my father.
Now's your chance. He died in the line of duty, didn't he?
That's fucked up.
Don't shoot. You cannot afford to miss, bro. You gotta make sure your shot counts.
Yeah.
Don't just shoot blindly. And they're shooting the whole place out.
They really are. This is a gunfight.
Oh, these guns in the neighborhood. Where's the cops at? Oh, wait. These are the cops.
Yeah.
Good. Blast them. Yep, tacticals, like a GTA mission. In GTA missions, in Red Dead Redemption missions, the location is your fucking friend. That's how you could take out 50, 60 people. Honestly, know your location, stealth in between. Pow! Every shot counts.
Honestly, this reminds me more of Call of Duty Zombies. You're just like stuck in a fucking place, just waiting for the... Just trying to board things up, make sure the zombies don't come in.
I'm always comparing this to that. I'm saying, I'm getting advice on how they should approach it. I didn't realize Call of Duty had zombies in it.
Yep. Famous game mode for years. It's 2008.
I just know Call of Duty Modern Warfare. I know of a Call of Duty Infinite Warfare.
Ironically, Call of Duty Advanced Warfare kept Kevin Spacey in it.
Ooh! Killed a lot of guys.
Yeah, they really did.
Why do when like the opposition, they always do dumb shit, they just run into the middle of some place. So you get shot, stick, so you look, the location is your friends. Always stay behind shit and shoot. You don't charge into an open space with nowhere to duck.
Exactly.
That's how you get blasted, idiot. He's trying to end this shit quickly, hoping, oh yeah, I can go in and shoot him. Boom, no, stupid. Don't be caught up because you have more numbers.
Yeah, they should
have tried. They're skilled shooters, it doesn't matter.
They should have tried to set the building on fire or something.
Yeah, that's what they should do. They set the building on fire. Throw some Molotovs in it.
Oh, no, he's right there.
Who is he?
You are. You're the guy who gets away with it. Jack knew it. So do I.
Oh, you're fucked.
Yeah.
Hit him right in his face. No, fuck this. No, fuck that. Fuck trying to arrest him. You put a hole in his head. Fuck him. All the things he's done. I get it. Really be satisfying, but I'm sorry. If I have him right here, man, I gotta blast him. I gotta blast
him. Are you gonna shoot me?
No, of course not.
Or arrest me.
It's not his character. That's not who he is.
He should, though. Should put one right in your friend's face.
That's what Russell Crowe would have done.
Or was the politician. Let me do the talking. After I've done, then make you chief of detectives.
He's gonna kill himself.
Your badge so they'll know you're a policeman.
I said shoot him, yeah. How's that feeling? That look in his eye, yeah.
He deserved it.
Yeah, he did. He definitely did.
Don't say this. Well, he went up over Joe, but first he could skirt it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of guy that could slippery. Yeah. On top of that, he deserves it. I can't have him right there with a gun in his face and up blows up.
You think you can talk your way out of this, Lieutenant?
Fuck that guy.
No, but I think I can tell the truth.
During our investigation of events surrounding the Night Owl case, Jack Vincennes, Bud White, and I learned the following.
Your golden boy is throwing his whole life away.
Three Night Owl suspects, while guilty of kidnapping and rape, were innocent of the multiple homicides at the Night Owl. The actual gunmen were most likely Los Angeles Police Department officers Michael Bruning and William Carlisle, and a third man who may or may not have been Captain Dudley Smith. The objective? The elimination of another police officer, Richard Stensland, who, along with former LAPD officer Leland Buzz Meeks, also committed multiple homicides on behalf of Captain Smith. And then betrayed him over 25 pounds of heroin, the retrieval of which was the ultimate motivation behind the night of
this
heroin.
Is all horrible. Disgraceful. Actually.
Beginning with the incarceration of Mickey Cohen.
Badge. Puts the uphole up, which is the
Smith
biggest criminal of them all.
Control of organized crime in the city of Los Angeles.
He's a mobster who has
this
a badge.
The assassinations of an unknown number of Mickey Cohen lieutenants. Systematic blackmail of city officials,
and the murders of Susan Lefferts, Pierce Patchett, Sid Hutchins, and Sergeant Jack Vincennes. Captain Smith admitted as much to me before I shot him at the Victory Motel. That's it.
We're in the wrong place.
Well, the press is going to have a field day with this. This, Christ, it'll stain the department for years.
Decades. If we can get the kid to play ball, who's to say what happened? Maybe Dudley Smith died a hero.
Good idea. Hmm? Yeah, if we can get the press to play.
Of course. The only heroes have to save their own looks. Try to be the hero in people's eyes.
You want to tell me what you're smiling about? A hero.
How do you know what we were talking about?
He couldn't have heard us.
And in this situation, you'll need more than one.
It is with great pleasure that I present this award, Detective Lieutenant Edmund Exley, two-time Medal of Valor recipient.
Wow. He hit the trip to further his own career when asked.
Next year, the LAPD will move into its new facility. With leaders like Lieutenant Edmund Exley, the image of fat
this
cops
just
stealing
you,
apples will be left
makes you feel,
forever.
You know, this fuck cops limit the limit the entire police department.
Yeah. All the scumbags in this movie. What, you two gonna be a thing now?
They're using me, so for a little while I'm using them.
This movie's disgusting.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, he's alive.
Oh.
I thought he was dead.
Yeah. Why not? I guess he's a trooper. You guys want to kiss?
Thanks for the push.
I'm assuming he can't speak yet. Some tube is going to his...
No, I'm assuming he's looking at him.
Yeah.
Yeah. He has a hole in his mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Exley.
Suck a dick.
Some men get the world. Others get ex-hookers and a trip to Arizona. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, I'm like, all right, fine, fuck it.
He's not doing our job.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man. I just oh shit. Yeah, man. This movie's good.
It is.
It's really good.
Yeah.
One of the best detective movies I've seen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It really shows you. It's really a movie about police. It's a really movie about police corruption.
Oh, it definitely is. Absolutely is. Every cop in this movie is just so damn corrupt. They're all like even the good ones have their own motivations, and like they all have their own agendas and shit.
Yeah, they move like the mob.
They really do. They really, really do. Like, honestly, the main bad guy, he's just a mob boss. That's all he really
essentially
is.
Essentially, yeah.
Yeah. He is. Like, he's just cutting loose ends. He's just fucking killing so many people in this movie. So many characters die.
Oh, so many bodies.
Honestly, I was just so shocked that Russell Crowe lived.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be a statistic in this movie.
Yeah, because it really would have measured up the amount of times he's, like, was broken the laws and been physically brutalized people, you know what I mean? Like,
mm-hmm. Petting crimes on people who are convenient suspects.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just,
wow. He moves like them, but I guess he was like for the good guys, I guess.
For the good guys. I mean, clearly he's doing it for his own selfish gain.
So it's, yeah, because his own sense of vengeance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Everyone here is this very... Again, even the heroes of this movie are just kind of self-centered in a way.
Yeah.
Like, they all have their own definitions of what's right and wrong and what they deserve and all these things. And they'll act on it without much regard for anyone else.
Exactly. They showed all these cops as egotistical dicks.
Yeah.
And none of them actually do what their job is supposed to be, which is to serve and protect.
Mm-hmm.
It's just all about serving yourself.
It is.
And fuck the civilians.
Mm-hmm. It's about how people who make justice are not actually just.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's fucked up.
Oh, responsible for upholding justice.
Yeah. Everyone has a different standard for justice, and they're all going to hold it differently, and all really not well, to be honest. They'll do it pretty badly.
Yeah, I mean, they're not even trying to do good.
Yeah, not really.
They're just being corrupt assholes.
Mm-hmm. Even Guy Pearce is kind of corrupt to a bit, because he's like, hey, I'll lie about the captain as long as it gets me ahead.
Yeah, he abandoned his old principles.
Yeah.
To get ahead. Fuck him, too.
Mm-hmm.
Crowe at least is straightforward, you know, I guess.
Yeah, he is.
Honestly, one of the best people was probably Kevin Spacey.
Ironically.
Ironically, yeah.
Yeah. But anyways, this is a good movie. But I'm definitely going to start recommending this to people. Anyone who wants to watch neo-noir anyway.
You need to watch. As far as that, yeah, this is solid.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. That being said, folks, please make sure you hit the like, subscribe button. Thanks again for joining us, everybody. We'll catch you next time for some more content.